Stable Diffusion 2 prompts differently. You need to use negative prompts because then you can go from images like this to images like this, including words like disfigured, kitsch, ugly, oversaturated, low res, deformed, blurry, tells Stable Diffusion what not to include. And this is having a dramatic effect on the quality of images coming out of Stable Diffusion 2. To use the negative prompts in a web UI like this one, all you have to do is copy this list and paste it into the negative prompt text box here. And then you can go ahead and generate your image. And you can see it goes from that all the way up to this. The reason why negative prompts are carrying such a greater importance in Stable Diffusion version 2 is because the model process deduped and flattened latent space, so negative prompts and weighting has a huge impact. Many people have been complaining about Stable Diffusion 2 being a downgrade. The fact the anatomy has taken a backward step, that there's no celebrities, that there's no naked nudity included, has angered many users. But it has definitely taken a step forward in other ways. I think the detail and coherence of images is working much better. The still life and landscapes are vastly improving. And it's becoming easier to train the model on your own datasets. Somebody has already trained the model on a few images of Taylor Swift and is getting some excellent results. Here is an example image. It's absolutely stunning. Emad Mostak, the father of Stable Diffusion himself, has been saying, like, actually try it, folks. It's only going to get better from here. Each of these was generated in a couple of seconds with some really beautiful examples of work from Stable Diffusion 2. Many of the benefits of Stable Diffusion also cause inverse difficulties. For example, the fact that it's open source and can be easily modified, upgraded, and changed means that there's endless possibilities to add and remove functionality, but it makes it more difficult to create a coherent user experience for people to be able to switch between or to create good learning materials that are applicable from one platform to another, from one version of Stable Diffusion to another. So in one way that you're gaining with one hand and losing with the other. I'm a great fan of this technology and what they've been creating, and I'm only expecting it to improve. So remember to use those negative prompts. Here's a video on the quickest way to install Stable Diffusion 2, and here's a video looking at all of the other new features available in this version. I hope you enjoyed this video. Why not stick around for more AI art news? I'm Samson Vols. This is Delightful Design, and I hope you have a delightful day.